Hey, what's up everybody? Too Tall Toby here, and today we're going to talk about how to use the totally free version of Onshape and create our own new custom materials library. Now, for the past couple of weeks, I've been creating several tutorials in Onshape on how to create some parts that are coming from the Too Tall Toby channel. Maybe they're coming from the Model Monday Live challenges or the practice models or the leaderboard challenges. Regardless of where they're coming from, all of these different challenges utilize one of three possible materials: plain carbon steel, which has a density of 7,800 kilograms per cubic meter, 1060 aluminum alloy, which has a density of 2,700 kilograms per cubic meter, and ABS, which has a density of 1020 kilograms per cubic meter. Well, I would really like to create a custom library of materials that contains these three materials. It's going to make it much faster for me to work through some of these challenges. So today, I'm going to show you how we can do this. We'll start out by going here to Onshape and taking a look at our documents page. Now, these are the documents that are owned by me, but what I want to do is switch over to the public documents library. And in the search up top, I'm going to type in std.mat. I press enter, and that shows me the results of the standard materials library. And I'm looking for the one that's owned by Onshape. So I'm going to click on that std.mat, and this shows me the entire out-of-the-box library of Onshape materials. But what I want to do is make a custom version of this library. And so you can see here it says this document is view only, make a copy to edit. So that's what I'm going to do, and I'll call this ttt-custom Onshape materials. And I'll say create a public document. And now we can see that public document has been created, TTT custom Onshape materials. And we get this nice list of instructions here. To edit this material library, right click on the tab and click export to download a CSV file. Edit the CSV file to add or remove new materials, then save your changes. Right click on this tab and click update, then choose your saved CSV file. So I really like the way Onshape is always right there to guide you through any of these processes. It's not confusing at all. It just tells you exactly what you need to do. So we start out by right-clicking on this tab at the bottom and choosing Export. And that will download a local copy of that CSV. Now I'm going to double-click on that local copy, and I'm going to open that up into my local version of Excel. And I'm going to modify this to include those three materials, the TTT materials. So for example, the very first material here in the library is ABS. Well, I'm not really that worried about the structural properties of this material. I'm just worried about the density. So I'm just going to rename that to TTT ABS, and I'm going to change the density here to 1020 to match the Too Tall Toby density for ABS. Now, these other properties over here are important when you're doing any kind of structural analysis. But like I said, for today's application, I'm really not worried about those. So I'm just going to leave those as they were from the Onshape library. Similarly, I'm going to go down here to aluminum 1060. So I'll delete all of these rows down to aluminum 1060. And then I'll take the aluminum 1060 and I'll just rename that to TTT-aluminum 1060. And then finally, I'll come all the way down to some type of steel down here. I don't know if it really matters which one. So I'll just come all the way down here to the steel grade 2. And I'll delete everything before that. And then I will finish up by deleting everything after. So I'm holding shift here to select all of those rows and deleting them. I'll rename this one to TTT-plain carbon steel. And I will match the density here to my library. So that should be 7,800 kilograms per cubic meter. And this one should be 2,700, which, hey, it happens to already be 2,700. So that's great. So at this point, I'm ready to do a save as. I'm going to save this as, instead of Onshape material library, I'll call this one TTT-custom Onshape materials. And now I'm going to close that CSV on my local machine, and back in Onshape, this third step here, right click on the tab and click update. So I'm going to right mouse button down here and choose update. And then I'm going to browse to that CSV, and I'm going to update the CSV into my Onshape materials library. Now, the final thing that I'm going to do is rename this Onshape material library tab. So I'm going to right mouse button and choose properties, and I'm going to rename that to TTT custom materials. And that way, when I am in the actual Onshape interface, I'll be able to tell the difference between the Onshape material library and the Too Tall Toby custom materials. So I'll say apply and close. So now that I've renamed that material library, the last thing I need to do here in this list, step number four, create a version. So I'm going to say create a version. I'll just call it V1. I don't really need a description for this. I just need to create this so that I can access it from the Onshape interface. And now I'm ready to return to the Documents tab and to the documents that are owned by me. We can see here we've got this TTT custom Onshape material, so that's a good sign. Let me open up this document here. This is a document that I've worked on before when I was creating a tutorial. And so I know that the mass of this part is supposed to be 1891, but I also know that that's because of a custom density that I applied kind of on the fly while I was doing that tutorial. Let's do it the correct way now by assigning a material. So we right mouse button, we say edit material, and we're gonna say that this is gonna come from a library, but it's gonna come from a new library. So I'm gonna say add material library, and I'm gonna add the TTT custom materials. So I say add, and now we can see that we've got some different choices here. We've got the TTT ABS, the aluminum 1060, or the plain carbon steel. Let's make it ABS, which is incorrect. It should be plain carbon steel. And let's take a look at the mass properties. And so the mass is now 247. Remember, it's supposed to be 1891. And so now I'm gonna right mouse button and I'm gonna say edit material. And I'm gonna change that to the TTT plain carbon steel. I'm gonna hit the green check mark, look at the mass properties, and oh yeah, that's what we wanted, 1891 when we're using the material from our library. So similarly, I've got this other document here, this purple part, which I also modeled in a tutorial and which I also just used kind of a temporary density to come up with the correct answer. This is supposed to be made of 1060 aluminum, and so it's supposed to have a mass of 0.686. So let's go in here and change our material. Let's change to the TTT library here. And we're gonna say that this is gonna be using the TTT plain carbon steel. Now let's look at the mass properties of this thing, 1.982 pounds. And this model is in pounds, which is another real benefit of having this library pre-configured. It makes it much easier for me. I don't have to spend as much time changing my units and doing conversions. I just pick the material and I'm good to go. So let's edit the material again, and let's change it to the correct material now and see if we can get that correct number for the mass. And so now when we look at the mass, there we go. That's what we wanted, that 0.686 pounds. So that is the process of creating your own custom materials library, adding some materials to that library, editing some existing materials, changing the name of the materials library so that you can tell the difference between the standard Onshape materials library and the new custom materials library here, adding the materials library here in this window by using the plus, and then assigning those materials to your model. I think we pretty much covered everything, but if you do have any questions, let me know down in the comments below. If you have any additional suggestions for me, let me know that as well. And of course, if you're enjoying this series, be sure to like, be sure to subscribe, and be sure to come back for the next episode. And I will see everyone there.